Welcome to Marlowe House Presents. I'm Andrew Marlowe.
You told me to be quiet.
Really? We're gonna play that game now?
Hold on. I'm the funny one here.
That's what you let. That's what we let you think. I'm Monica Marlowe.
I'm so confused.
Help me.
My whole sense of identity is gone.
Look right here and say that again.
Help me.
Tonight, we are going to play, we hope.
Taped to the chair.
Tonight, we're going to be playing what we hope is the last episodes of Scoundrels of a Stranger Sky. And it's not duct tape. It's super glue. What have I told you?
If it turns
it
out it's not the last.
On its skin.
If it turns out it's not the last episode, donations to make it the last episode can be sent to
patreon.com marlowe.com/marlowehouse.
Oh boy.
That's another movie we should have Kate watch.
Maybe not.
She probably would not enjoy that.
No.
I'm pretty sure she won't enjoy any of the movies we've suggested.
She might like a couple of them. One or two.
Oh, there I am.
There you are. Oh, you showed up. Well, it's about time. It's not like you don't have Wi-Fi. So, how was everybody's week while Andrew makes sure everything's running? Scott.
Andrew, if you don't adjust the lid on that, I'm going to get you a booster seat.
The what? Oh, you...
Yeah.
That'll look great in like 6 minutes.
An hour from now. And I moved.
Oh, there he goes.
Oh, I nope. Stopped. I stopped. Nope. We stopped moving on mine. But I look so cute. Oh, come on.
Oh, the feather on my hair is just on point tonight.
You do look very nice, Scott. I'm glad you showed up today. Mostly because then I don't have to just talk to Andrew. It's always so much more awkward when it's just the two of us.
You gotta find better movies to talk about.
Oh, well, all right, so speaking of talking and it just being the two of us.
Yes.
Tuesday.
Oh, yes, Tuesday we're going to talk with
Segways are hard.
And how.
Yes, from Samurai Sheepdog.
Samurai Sheepdog. Because he's publishing a book with our stories in it. I have no video. I guess it's a good thing we wrote books instead of games. This is so weird. Anyway, so, I guess I don't need to watch the video. I can watch us live.
Right.
In color.
In the room, even.
In the room, even.
Yeah, because Martin's not doing
it. That means interacting. I don't like this.
I know. I really don't like people. So anyway, so next Tuesday, and presumably every Tuesday thereafter,
that is
at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is exactly the time it is right now on a different day.
Right.
This is a Friday. That will be a Tuesday. We're going to only talk for about a half hour, though. We're going to keep it kind of short and sweet. Not like we do now.
Well, we're gonna try to.
Yes.
We'll see how that goes.
Yes.
I'm not certain how that goes.
It depends on how long we talk.
But it goes.
And we'll see how this what the format looks like. But this week it'll be an interview episode. We're going to talk with Hal. We're going to talk about The Awakened Isle of Bones, the current Kickstarter, and we're going to see maybe how Awakened all got started.
Uh-huh.
Maybe talk about some of the past volumes and maybe just discuss the short story that our three names are on, you know.
Yeah, because, you know, there's that thing. But it's going to be a shorter show. It'll be about a half hour. It's not going to ramble on and on and on.
We hope.
We do. No, because I have to work in the morning.
I know, that's why I said we hope.
Yeah, no, it'll be done in a half an hour.
Well, if not, you'll be done in a half an hour.
Yes, I will pumpkin out.
You'll pumpkin out.
So, and nobody wants to see you and Hal just talk.
Probably not.
Because I am the star of the show. I like this. I like this rig we have set up better for our cameras, because now I can actually see your face rather than all the crap between you and me.
It's such a it's a better rig.
It is a better rig. So we can.
So instead of stacking everything up really tall.
Yeah, I know. I can't believe it took me that long to figure that out. I feel dumb. But it's fixed it.
It's fixed
and
it.
And it is good. So. So we have a game to finish.
We do.
Please. No, it's not that. Actually, I kind of like this. It's just weird.
Right.
Actually, it's really strange really playing with three people all the time. I'm kind of looking forward to going back to our Saturday game. And I mean, I don't mind playing our Friday night games because I know we're going to continue to play Friday nights. But it is a little strange playing with just the three of us. That did not come out right, and I promised to do
phrasing
better.
At least we're doing it in front of an audience so they know exactly what it is that we're talking about.
No, we're doing it in front of Michael McNeil. Hi, Michael! And
most of these episodes have been in front of more than Michael.
I know. I'm mostly just joking.
And then they go up on YouTube.
And a few bots.
And a few bots. Many, many bots like to watch our show. We're obviously very popular among the artificial crowd. Actually, there's about three or four, I've noticed.
There's only two right now.
Is there? Oh, well. I hope Apricot Droop shows up soon because it'll miss out on... Is it? Oh, okay.
It's there. So is Commander Root.
Oh, well, Slow-Mo's not there then. But anyway, yeah, it's pretty sad.
It's really sad when we've gotten to know...
The bots.
If you take them out drinking, they're very nice.
Yes, they are.
They pay.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Apricot Droop fruits here. And Commander Root. Yep. Because there are two of our usual watchers watching bots.
Michael.
Hi, Michael.
Because he's saying hi again.
He's not a bot.
He's not a bot.
Don't let them fool you, Michael. You're not a bot.
I didn't say he was a bot.
I really feel sad because Opportunity used to watch us, but it has stopped.
Did we reach Mars?
Yeah, Opportunity was there for years, you big dork.
You've got a heck of a signal.
It's the Apple product. Oh, I'm sorry.
So
maybe that means Elon's listening to us too.
God, that would be awesome. I wish he would retweet us. So yeah. Anyway.
That would be cool.
This means we gotta start mentioning Mars.
Right. So speaking of which, and supporting us, if you have not followed us yet on YouTube, please go search for Marlow House on YouTube, because we don't have a cool URL there yet. And we need about 100 people following us there to get a cool URL. We are really excited that we do have 50 followers here on Twitch, which means that we will have a better reach and we'll start hitting some of the metrics here to help promote our show. And if you really like what you're watching, and who doesn't like watching us act like fools on every Friday night, you can find us at patreon.com/MarlowHouse, and you can fund this madness. And
this
we would
madness.
Really appreciate it.
This madness.
This madness.
This very madness.
This very madness right now. I'm pretty sure our next game is going to be Call of Cthulhu. I called it.
Dibs on Cthulhu.
Wait a minute.
As long as I get to play it's Shogun. That's all that matters to me. I have the tentacle crown, though. I'm going to have to call dibs. If you can come up with better tentacle jewelry than I can, you can be Cthulhu.
My own tentacle.
Whoa! Twitch has rules!
I have
standards.
That's what she said.
Thank you.
Mwah. Good night, everybody.
Well, that was a fast show. See y'all next week.
To make this the last episode of Scoundrels of a Stranger Sky, send donations too.
Now, we're hoping that they don't want to make it the last episode. It's not.
You want to see us do something else stupid? Patreon.com/MarlowHouse.
Yeah, we're good at stupid.
Yes, we are. I really do have some really nice tentacle jewelry I'd love to wear. Again. I've worn it before.
So. When last we played?
I was playing Alara Gebbins, who's a lucky explorer who looks for trouble.
I was playing Zotch Colbin, who's just getting into trouble that you're looking for.
I think we should swap characters.
Well, actually, I believe you don't do much.
I don't do much. That's probably why I land in so much trouble.
But this week, I believe we were starting with a very big guy going, "You're going to be paced."
Yeah, we're going to miss you, dude.
Yeah.
Thank you for showing up.
Oh, I should probably have my character sheet.
You know, that would probably be helpful.
Oh,
cover me.
God.
I'm going in.
So we've been sitting here
for an hour.
For over an hour. Doing tests and sound tests.
Listening to music, talking, watching him art.
Yeah, to be fair, I was doing a lot of art.
Well,
ta-da.
At least.
This is what it's like every Sunday night.
No, every Sunday night.
There's three more people who do the same thing.
And we would still be getting, we wouldn't, I'd be going, all right, so we're about to start, and then somebody else would cascade us off into some other topic, like I'm having to fill for right now, because somebody's got to pick out his dice. One at a time.
Just dump the bag.
I gotta find the good ones.
There are no good ones.
No, there are good ones.
They all look the same. All right.
Okay.
So... Yeah, he does make stupid look good. That's true, Michael.
It's the hair.
It is the hair. Maybe he's born with it. Maybe it's Maybelline. We'll never know. All right. So, Scott's character is about to get smushed.
Or at least that's what we want everyone to think.
Well, why don't you just ruin it, man?
So something went horribly wrong again.
What happened?
And our chat stuff is not cooperating still. So you're not going to see it get really big as I go and try to fix it.
Okay, I just got up to go get my stuff.
No, actually,
so you got
you're
time.
Back. On mine, you're already back.
What?
Why, no.
I'm
I live
a
in
time
the future.
Traveler.
I live in the future.
We all live in different timelines. All right, so we've got something up now. Okay. Like I said.
Yay.
It said it was there. I don't know why it wasn't displaying, but it wasn't. Oh. Just to make sure, I'm going to just go ahead.
I just did that. Okay, there we go. Oh, now it's showing up.
Yeah, it's because I fixed it. I put in a new one.
Oh, I see.
I put in a new one and hid the old one in case it decided to show up. We wouldn't get double print. Because, you know, that's what would happen to me.
Well, then we would see double. And that would be bad. And that keeps you in the hospital an extra day.
Yeah.
Then true story. Have an MRI. It's a true story. And then you have to see a neurologist later.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun.
All right. So are you ready? Dice, everything?
I got stuff.
All right, so are we rolling initiative or what?
I guess we're rolling initiative.
Are we rolling initiative?
Looks
yeah.
Like you're rolling
no,
initiative.
No, getting pounded sounds like doing stuff. I don't like that.
I rolled a natural 20. Woo!
Way to waste a 20.
I know. That'll be the last one I get all day. Can I spend an XP to save that for another? Reroll for a
that's
better?
That's not how that works.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty certain that's not how that works.
We opened a bank account, right? Yeah. She would like to bank that natural 20.
Maybe that's what I should do with those markers that Lynette came up with.
What, you bank a 20?
Yeah.
And roll another one?
That's not a bad idea.
Actually, that's a pretty cool idea. Because you know I'm never going to roll a 20 again for the next 48 to 72 hours.
Right.
Although, to be fair, those dice do seem to like you.
They do seem to like
me. They like you better than some of the other dice you've had.
I know. I should have people pick out dice for me more often.
Well... We had professionals pick out dice for you, and they aren't that lucky.
I know. Anyway, so come on, Scott. Roll initiative. We're waiting on you, man.
Initiative. 2.
I'm assuming that... Nah, it doesn't matter. All right. So, Monica, what... Are you trained in initiative or
anything? I'm trained in initiative. initiative too. I have.
Are you really?
Or oh no 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 no. I'm sorry. I have speed defense. I'm not trained in initiative. I have speed defense. My bad. Okay.
So.
No, I am stealthy though.
A 20 is a 6.
Yes, it is. This guy goes on a 7. Really? Are you telling me that this guy who's just, that this guy who just walked off the planet really? Really?
Officer Meat Mountain?
Yeah.
Yes. He's going first.
I'm very disappointed in you as a storyteller. I'm just going to say that right now. As a GM. All right. Go ahead. Kill Scott. I don't mind.
He does go first.
All right.
So, he basically kind of like lunges down at you.
He's going to jump down the stairs at me.
He's going to run down them. I mean, he's kind of...
That's just foolish. He's asking to fall over.
He is asking for trouble.
Yes, he is. You know, looking at my character sheet, we should have slept before we did this. Anyway!
I assumed that we did, because this is like the next day.
Is this the next day?
It is the next day.
Oh, excellent. Now I'm going to have some chance of actually replenishing. I forgot. It's been a whole week. How do I know what time it is?
Need my book.
All right.
So he does like one of those anime run leaps down the staircase to try and grab Scott by the neck and wring it.
That's why he goes before me, because I'm busy laughing at his ass.
So you can go ahead and make a speed defense roll. And this will actually be a little bit easier because of the fact that he is coming down the stairs and is an awkward way to come at you.
Fortunately, I actually have some speed defense.
All right, so you can count an asset because he's coming down at you awkwardly.
Okay.
And then your speed defense, so what is that?
And I think I would also like to throw one effort at that.
Okay.
Because I don't have a whole lot of speed.
All right, so you're putting one level of effort at it.
One level of effort.
Okay. And then you said you had speed defense?
Mm-hmm.
Just trained in?
Yeah, just trained. And I have a 12.
Well, as luck would have it, that's your number.
Yay!
That was your number. So he kind of comes down at you and, like, grabs empty air where your neck was just moments before. Monica.
Yes.
You're up, and because you rolled a 20 and he has come down the stairs a little bit off balance, you have an asset for striking him if you wish to.
Well,
or, you know, acting against him in any way, shape, or form.
As luck would have it, I have a longsword and I'm not afraid to use it. So, with that asset, it lowers my difficulty by 3. Mm-hmm. I've rolled a 16.
That's enough to hit.
Well, that's excellent. I do 10 points of damage.
Wow.
I don't mess around.
You do really not. So what does that look like?
Well, that looks like he comes down, and as he's coming down, I bring my sword up and through his shoulder.
Okay. So you gouge it.
Possibly partially severing his arm from his body.
Not quite that much, but it is definitely...
He's going to really have a hard time throttling my friend.
You do a good gash on him. There is a spray of red as you do this.
Well, I didn't know how much damage I did, so...
You did like half of what he has.
Good. That'll teach him to mess with us.
So, you don't do much. Are you just going to, like, let your friend take care of this?
Apparently.
Can I make another speed defense to avoid the spray?
Sure.
It's going to be sticky here.
That could be your action.
18 on the die.
Okay.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Why are we fighting and cutting each other? I wanted to find this man.
Well, he appears to be hurt, but okay.
He just gives out a bestial roar and lunges at Monica now.
You better have a reason to want him, because I'm about to kill him.
Do what you gotta do.
Did you really want to find him?
I did, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, well, shit. All right. Well, as luck would have it, I can actually knock him out. It's going to cost me a lot. All right. Let me know when it's my turn again.
Okay. He lunges at you, so go ahead and give me a speed defense.
I have some of that.
He comes at you with both fists.
All right.
So go ahead and you can make two speed defense rolls.
Okay, I'm going to spend effort on each of those.
Just make sure you don't spend more effort than your
limit. I've only spent two so far.
Right, but I mean, these would be...
I can spend up to six.
Okay.
I know how to count. Unfortunately, I rolled eights on both of those, but they are both reduced by three.
Okay. So
they're the equivalent of fives.
Right. Now.
Yes.
You only reduced it by three total.
Mm-hmm. That's all I reduced it by.
Okay. So, seven. And then, so five would be like rolling.
So it was like rolling a 15.
Right. Okay. Yeah. I see what you're saying. I'm doing it the other way and okay. Now I'm no longer confused. He hits.
Okay.
So go ahead and take 12 points.
Okay.
And if you've got armor, you can reduce each of those. You can reduce it by your armor twice.
Okay.
Because that's two separate hits.
Six each?
Six each.
Okay. All right.
Also, she hits a lot harder than I do.
My turn?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's too bad he spent all my might hitting me. I'm going to have to kill him now. I will spend five might to not kill him. And... I will still hit him with the sword, but in the head.
All right, so you basically...
To knock him out.
Are you going to hit him like the handle then?
Yes.
The hilt?
Yes.
Okay.
So that reduces it by... two, and then... I'll reduce it by a third. So reduce by three. Spend a lot to not kill him.
Okay.
I only rolled a 10.
Actually, yeah. Okay.
19.
That'll hit. And you do. So you're just knock. That just knocks him out.
Right.
How does that work? Is it just.
I crack him in the head really
good.
Just,
it just makes him go.
And it just. Whatever damage is done is non-lethal, basically.
Okay. And then you would do extra.
Oh, yeah. I am not happy.
So, okay.
He better be worth it.
He crumples.
Your uniform is ruined.
I'm not going to fit in his uniform anyway.
Well, neither is he. Now he's spilling out of it.
He's not dead. They'll be fine.
I I was basically gonna send him on his way to the girl with the bottle of orcish bourbon.
Well, maybe you should have told me that before we got here.
I was counting on him finding me.
Maybe you should have shared that with me before we got here.
I thought you were going in a different way.
I don't know. The storyteller told me I was here. I'm just following what we were told. I have no idea. Maybe you should have shared that with us, too.
I don't remember that you were going in a different way, but I could have made a mistake.
I don't remember that I was going in a different way, either.
That's why I thought you were looking at the like the garbage chutes and stuff.
Yeah, but we have to get there.
Right. Right. I'm the guy that blends. I can just walk the hallways.
No, you can't. Right. Not up there, you can't. Maybe we should have discussed what our plan was before we went about this, because we did it all half-assed last week in different orders. What is our plan?
You guys, as far as I know, your plan was to go up, get into the elevator system, which you are on your way to now.
Right, which is what I thought we were doing. We were going to go up the elevator and then escape through the chute, not that we were going to go up separately.
Okay.
I thought you guys were going to split up when you got further up.
Yeah, that would work.
Obviously, we
but
have
now,
two different...
But now there's arterial spray everywhere.
Well, you know what? Sometimes bad things happen. That's why it was called an intrusion. I can't help it that you were banking on me intruding on that.
All right.
That was the most obvious one.
All right.
And you set me up. And I set you up.
All right. I definitely need to heal. This is not good.
Now we gotta hide him.
At least he's not dead.
Maybe that's not a good thing.
We shall see.
Actually, I've got a better idea. Let's take him up the elevator with us.
Okay.
We're being attacked.
All right.
And then we can attack the guards that are up there, and then we don't have to worry about who's up there.
I didn't necessarily want to kill anybody because, you know, we're in the past. We don't know how that's going to affect the future.
He's not dead yet. They're not dead yet. We just have to be careful about how we don't dead them.
All right.
I'm very good at breaking things. Doesn't mean I have to kill them. We're never letting Andrew GM for us again.
Now, wait a minute.
All right, so is that what we're going to do now?
That means one of you has to do it.
I guess we'll let Andrew GM for us for the future. So is that what we want to do? What do you want to do?
I feel like that's going to draw way too much attention.
Okay.
I like to get in, get out.
All right. Well, we still have to get up there.
Well, her, I think her plan is that you would go up and you would tell those guards that you're under siege. And while they're trying to, you know, help you take care of the poor bastard who's been...
Half gutted.
You turn and them out and then you've got free reign of the upstairs.
That's kind of my thought.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay.
I can go with that.
All right, so all of that shit that we did for the last 2 weeks... We're totally undoing it. We're doing this instead.
This works.
All right.
It all works together. We're good.
Okay. Then that's what we're going to do.
This is the improvising in the middle of things when things went sideways.
Yes, because all good plans go sideways when once they hit actual, you know, action.
Right.
This isn't like Ocean's 11.
Nah.
12.
It is.
13. Things go sideways.
So,
should we haul this guy up to the elevator?
Right. So you go up the elevator.
Mm-hmm.
Doors start to open.
Uh-huh.
And what are you guys doing? Because I'm assuming you're going to start the charade before the doors open.
Oh, yeah. We've got this guy. We're like holding him up. And, like, I'm on the bloody side. Because, well.
I'm kind of like
holding pressure and. Actually, maybe we'll leave him sitting in the elevator so they have to come to us.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Okay.
And then when the doors open, we start yelling, you know, help, help, we
get help, 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 help us. Attack.
Help, help, my brother's
get help, injured. My brother's hurt.
I like how we both went there. They're strong enough to throw this guy at him? I don't think I am. I've got an 18.
You've got more than I do.
I don't think I can throw him. Throwing is not one of my strengths. So
you can spend effort on
maybe it. I can talk
I'm not throwing spend an effort to throw this dude. No.
Maybe I can talk him into throwing himself.
Go for it.
I don't think that's gonna work.
He's still unconscious. He probably will be for a while.
That is totally not good for you.
Quick, spill the orcish brandy on him, though. Wait.
I guess we got sweet orcish brandy to take back with us.
We're gonna need that for the trip home. All right. So So when the door opens, we're like, "Help! Help us get it! We're under attack."
All right. Somebody want to roll to?
You have more lies and trickery
to
than
run
I
that
do.
That run yep, that scam.
That's gonna be me 100%.
That's what I figured. So run your scam. How do you? What are you saying? And what are you rolling?
Oh, we're gonna die.
Well, I want to know how you're gonna actually say it.
I'm gonna spin it that the Emperor has. Infiltrators in the building.
Okay.
And that they've already attacked poor... What's his name tag say? I saw the roster. I forget what his name was.
You scrub it down and it says... Vance.
Vance caught them in the act and they attacked him. They're three floors down. I will use telling for the... I can't do two at once, can I? Wait, telling lasts for a couple minutes. I can do telling as I come up with the lie.
Okay.
And then I can use grand deception.
Okay.
As we get up topside.
All right. So go ahead and roll it.
All right. Specialized in deceiving.
That doesn't look like you're specialized in deceiving. Why don't you spend an XP on that?
Yes. I was trying to do like math in my head real quick.
It's only a single digit, dude. Yeah. I'm pretty sure you're not going to be able to skill in that.
19.
All right, so how much effort did you put on that?
I always throw my 2 free on it.
Okay.
Just as a thing. So it would be 2 for the effort, telling, trickery, that's 5. Do we get an asset for the bloodied body?
I can give you an asset for the bloodied body.
Yay! That's 6.
All right. So in that case, what did you roll?
A 19.
A lot.
19. That is a lot more than you needed.
And the 19.
I'm spinning a good yarn.
You are spinning a good yarn.
And the 19 gives you a major effect or a minor effect too.
So they like rush into the thing and start you know helping you with the body and trying to get the unconscious guy to come around, try to staunch some of that blood flow.
Okay, I hit one of them in the head. I spent 5 light to do that.
Okay. And they are distracted.
That's a 16 to hit one of them in the head and not kill him.
All right, so real quick, are you applying any effort to hitting him?
Yeah. Just 1, though. I only have so much money.
Okay.
Yeah, I really only have so much money. I mean, a 16 reduced by 1 with the actual specific ability to knock him out.
Okay.
I mean, so, I'm spending 5 might to do that.
I know.
That seems kind of...
Well, except there's still effort that gets applied to it as well. So, I mean, that's to do it. I mean, you still have to make connection.
I have to look at
that. So
I don't have my book, so I can't tell you exactly what Mike does. I've not used it before.
Oh, the knockout thing?
Yeah. All or right. With the knockout, not Mike.
That's all right. We'll just assume. I'm good with it for the moment. It's not going to add anything to you. It just means that you knock him out, probably. We can check it at the break.
Well, I know, but I mean, it didn't occur to me that spending 5 might to knock someone out is kind of a waste of might. I'd much rather spend 5 might to actually hit him.
Except that knocking him out will be easier. It's probably that one. I'm assuming it is that one shot cinematic knock somebody out, and that would be expensive.
Except that I do like 7 points of damage unarmed.
Yeah, but that's still not going to be enough to drop somebody in most cases.
All right.
Which ability is it?
Knockout.
Which level? 4.
I think it's like 4 or 5, or it must be like.
Is it an explorer?
3 or 4. Yeah.
Do 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 do. Looking up the things.
Okay. I couldn't find it in mine, and I don't know where the books went to.
They're probably upstairs. That's why I said we'll check with the break.
Okay. Well, I mean, if...
So you applied 1 level of effort for that.
I mean, if
and then you've got
6 is not enough to hit.
Do you have anything for hitting unarmed? Skills or anything?
No, I'm not trained in that. It would have to be with my longsword, which I am skilled, which I'm skilled with, which would be another 2.
Okay, so then what'd you roll?
16.
Great. That will be enough.
Okay. All right, so one of them goes down.
So you go, one of them. And the other one's like, what? And I think that's probably initiative.
13.
Did you roll a 2
again? I rolled a 2 again. My God!
You're still down there telling your story, totally oblivious to the fact that things are starting to go sideways. Or they're going exactly according to plan, but... And you rolled a what?
I rolled a 13. Is that a 13? Yeah, that's a 13.
Right, did you spend any effort on that?
No, because you said roll initiative, and I don't think to do Sergeant that.
Bibber.
Okay.
Unless I can spend some speed on it. Can I spend speed on my initiative?
You don't know whether you've succeeded or not. Yes, sure.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and spend 2 effort and speed.
Effort and speed.
Yes.
You go first.
Yay! I also hit him in the head. I'll also spend my. I'm gonna miss this might.
I'm gonna miss this might.
So 2, 6. And I'll reduce it by 2. And I'm also. I still got my sword in my hand, so another 2. So we'll reduce this by 4. And I rolled an 18.
Wow.
I really need
your dice are on fire.
Really need better glasses.
All right, so you hit him.
That's good. He's unconscious too, huh?
He is unconscious too.
We pull the stop on the elevator. We pull the stop on the elevator so that the elevator is stuck on this floor. And we change out to clean uniforms.
All right, so somebody disable the elevator for me.
It's a button. Any fireman can do it.
It's not a button on a magic elevator.
Magic.
Oh, for crying out loud, I have breaking things.
Break it.
I break it.
Okay, break it.
Go, Ralph.
Wreck it.
I'm talented in break, or I'm trained in breaking things.
I'll give you that.
And I rolled a 17.
That's solidly broken.
This elevator is going nowhere.
Where's this elevator going?
Nowhere. All right, but I also need to heal now because I have spent... all of my dice pool. All of my pool.
A really freaking big guy broke the elevator.
Sure, it was just the little girl. Anyway.
Cereal crusher.
Some huge freaking guy.
Hey now. Alright. I am now down so to good. Meeting. I am down now to needing an hour to rest if we don't find anybody else. What do you think chances are of that? Slim to none. All right.
So now you have the lock.
Oh, well, that would be
and
me
we,
again.
And we got the thing for that.
Oh, that's right. We got the thing for that.
We got the thing.
All right. Well, you got the thing. All I have is a sleeper bomb.
I've got the thing then.
Yes.
Okay. Well, I mean, I could have the thing. I mean, I'm skilled in lockpicking, so I mean, I could have the thing.
You're skilled in lockpicking. You should have
the thing. I have the thing. Okay. I take the thing over to the door.
Okay.
And I use it.
Okay. It's supposed to help you pick the lock.
All right. Is that an... that'll be an intellect, won't it?
Intellect or speed, whichever you want to do.
Well, I have a lot more intellect now than I have of anything else.
I will let it fly with either one.
Okay, so...
Because you can be clever to do it, or you can be, you know...
All right, I'm going to lower it by 2 in addition. That'll be 12. So, between lock picking and effort, it's lowered by 4.
Okay.
I don't know how I feel about an 8. I'm not sure I like the 8. Actually...
Use your luck power.
I'm going to use my luck power. I would like to re-roll... Well, it only affects me, so that's not... Yeah, I'm going to re-roll my... Okay. Well, no, I can only use that if I roll 1.
Oh.
I have the ability to add a 3 to a re-roll that affects only me, but I am assuming this does not affect only me. Unless...
Yeah, we can let it go. I can do that.
Well, if you're okay with that, then I'm happily re-roll and get a 5. I rolled a 3. Here, let me roll that. Oh, an 11. That's so much better than an 8.
So it's a 14.
Just plus 3.
No, she re-rolled
it. No, I had to re-roll it again.
Oh.
I had to re-roll it again. But I have an 11 that I lowered by 4. So it's an equivalent of a 7. How much XP are you sitting on over there?
No, you try.
Don't worry about it, because it's enough.
Okay, well, as long as it's enough.
Because with the gizmo, there wasn't a whole lot of...
Oh, okay.
That was the whole point of getting it.
Getting the gizmo.
Okay. Gizmo! Yay. I'm still...
Just don't beat it after midnight.
Got that.
No, an 8 would not have been enough.
Okay.
A nine would have been enough.
Yay, 11.
So, click, click. And the door opens. You hear a from the elevator.
Really? We just got up here. Could take care of that.
Can we, like, wedge the door shut?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay. You can do that, and you can see that they're not really the first guy isn't really that close to coming around, but he's in there moaning.
And because you cut him for 10 damage.
Well, I did that too. Hopefully, he doesn't bleed out. He'll never use that arm again, though. All right. Well, as long as he's not, you know. So we go in.
Not that this is intrusion worthy. But as you're pulling the doors closed and she's saying, he's probably never going to use that arm again, you, like, take another look at him. And pull the doors closed, like, oh yeah, he might need to do that. Because now that you get a good look at his outfit, it looks like gladiatorial gear.
I just injured one of the gladiators?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
I don't tell you that. Wow, yeah, you really did a number on him.
You picked poorly, man. Anyway. So we go into the vault.
Okay. And you go into the vault. You push open the doors, and it is like, it's like Scrooge McDuck's swimming pool.
Yeah.
There's just gold everywhere.
Must it remember just lays this is out a dragon's cold hoard. Must not touch.
We take the one thing.
There are gold vases and platinum, plates stacked up in stacks.
No.
Gemstones.
No. Walking in looking for them.
And you're like,
one thing we're here for. He would kill us when we got back if we took other things, because he would know it was us.
You pass by a number of crystal decanters that have glowing fluid in them.
And you, sounds like magic. I'm not into it.
You kind of keep wandering through and trying to keep your eye out for the scepter.
Well, then, that sounds like perception checks to me.
Yes.
Wow. 8 again. I don't see it the first time. What do you got over there, Scott?
I have read the signs.
Excellent.
So I'm going to start examining the place. Does identifying count for this?
I will give you that.
Excellent. Trained in that.
It's a big stick. And I mean, really?
And it's intellect, so I will apply my effort to it as well.
Okay.
Woo!
Keep it on the table.
So I'm assuming 2 points of effort.
Yep. So that was lowered by 3. It's a 9 on the die.
Okay.
Second roll. 9 on the die. That's not cool.
I'd rather roll 9s than 8s.
That's fair. That's fair.
At least that's a whole different
17.
Tier or level, yeah. 17?
17.
Ooh.
F that 3. Okay. Really?
Okay, so anyway.
There's a 3.
Another 3. It says you're having the 3.
So it's like, no, 3.
No, that's what you find.
So you, like, search around and you do, you kind of give it a good eyeball. With what you rolled, though, the amount of gold and gemstones and other things that are hoarded here are very distracting. And you're watching and you're looking and you're like, ooh, he must really like that. There's a space cleared over there. I can see where he, like, lays down and wait, no, that's not what we're looking for. And as much as I would love to have that, as much as I would love to have that very expensive Palantir-looking orb, I think I'm gonna pass.
No.
And after several minutes of, a couple minutes of looking, timing starts to make you start to kind of start getting a little worried about how long it's taking.
Can I roll enigmas to help speed this up?
Sure. So, while she's also looking around and trying to aid.
That's a 13.
You hear the elevator shutter.
18, and I am skilled in enigmas.
You can hear the elevator shutter as if it's trying to move down and failing.
I broke it.
Because you broke it. But obviously, somebody is trying to respond.
An 18 reduced by 2 and reduced by 2 to find where would a dragon keep this scepter.
Right. So you're like, no. You should be looking over probably closer to where it wouldn't be out in the open. It should be probably over there where those chests are. And sure enough, you look over like, oh, and this chest has recently been opened and closed. And you can see that there's a lot of stuff that's been moved off of it. Clearly things that were, like, swept off the top of it, coins or something, that's now piled up around on the other side of it. So, maybe in the chest.
Because this is important and time is starting to run short, will you read the signs one more time?
Okay.
And I'm going to throw all of my efforts at it.
Okay.
It's going to be 5 efforts.
Okay.
F that 5. 19.
Wow. Okay.
7.
You only need to roll the 1.
Okay. That's good.
That was plenty.
Okay.
So you're like, and what are you trying to figure out? Just like looking at it and.
Yeah, what would be where it would be looking at the way everything is laid out, because dragons are creatures of habit. What patterns are clearly showing? This is something he's going to have been obsessing over. What is going to be the most disturbed yet undisturbed?
Where is the scepter?
Well, no, it's probably in the chest. That's okay. Why I said the first time.
Okay.
In the chest.
Yeah. So, all right. So, given that, you know it's in the chest. I'll give you this, particularly since you rolled a 19. If you disturb several of the piles near where he was reclining and looking into that palantir and paying attention to things over there, if you were to, say, hide the palantir and disrupt a bunch of other stuff, he might not realize you came for the scepter first.
Yeah, we can do that.
Okay.
Shuffle the expensive stuff.
Okay.
Not that it's not all expensive.
We're about to steal the scepter of power for this entire system. I'm pretty sure there's nothing more expensive here than that. But okay. So we rearrange his stuff. I'm sure that'll make him very happy.
It probably will not.
He's a dragon. We're going to be lucky if he doesn't kill us.
Is there like a cloth covering the scepter or anything, or is it just like sitting out in the chest?
You open up the chest. The chest has actually got like form-fitted velvet inside that holds it.
And is it like, my God?
It's like dragon scaled. It's probably more like, it's almost more like a staff in size, but.
So it's staff size. So it's like 4 or 5 feet long for us.
Yeah, it's like staff length for a human, but it is about 3 inches in diameter.
I'm not sure we can get this down the shaft. The dumbwaiter?
Look at it?
Yeah.
It is actually separatable.
Well, thank God.
Small favors.
Yep.
Break it down.
Break it down.
Fortunately, it does break into 5 smaller pieces.
Oh, good.
At least it wasn't 7. That's a whole other story.
That's an entirely different story. We put those pieces in a bag.
Okay.
Obviously, we would have to have a bag.
I'm okay with that.
Because we're adventurers, and adventurers without bags.
You are scoundrels.
We're scoundrels. We don't have bags. We just don't know what we're doing.
You're sneak thieves.
Yes.
Especially tonight.
I don't know about that, but okay. We need to get the heck out of Dodge.
These thieves.
Because the elevator is trying to move.
Jump. Got to go.
So we make our exit.
Okay. Door is at the far end of the hallway.
Uh-huh.
As you come out into the hallway and are working your way into the dumpster shaft.
Uh-huh.
The double doors at the other end of the hallway that lead to the dragon's other apartments start to open.
Hi.
So go ahead and give me speed checks for speed and stealth.
So if I am skilled in speed defense and trained in stealth, what do you want?
Well, this is not for speed defense. It is just to be hasty and quiet.
19.
16 and...
You only need one. Oh. It's just for speed and quiet.
I rolled 16 on both.
So if you're trained in...
If you're trained in stealth,
it applies.
I am trained in stealth.
I'm trained in speed defense.
Okay.
He just said that speed defense doesn't count. He's a jerk.
Right?
I know.
Speed defense for stealth. What nonsense is this?
Speed and stealth.
In that case, I can use blend in.
Okay.
And then I will be specialized in stealth.
Okay.
All right, so we stealth.
So you successfully move into the The dumbwaiter, down, or the garbage chute?
I thought you said there was a garbage chute. Did you say there was a dumbwaiter here? Is it a dumbwaiter?
I thought there was one of both.
I don't know. You're the GM.
I thought I told you there was one of both.
Oh, okay.
But you were going to use the garbage chute, I thought, in retrospect, now that you're mentioning it.
I thought you said there was a garbage chute. I didn't think there was a dumbwaiter.
There is. It's a garbage chute.
All right. I'm glad one of us is paying attention. So we go that
I'm
route.
I'm paying attention. You say it like I'm not.
I know I'm not. So anyway, so we go down the garbage chute because...
Into the garbage chute.
Into the garbage chute, yes. And then we go down to the level...
All right, so you get into the garbage chute, and that's pretty much all you guys can do is kind of, like, stand on, like, the lip of the, you know, the edges inside.
Uh-huh.
And because it's a straight shot down, so you normally would have to climb. And since you're just trying to get in and quietly, safely, getting you both in basically puts one of you a body's length down, the other one kind of right at the entrance.
I have climbing, too. I'm not afraid.
Okay, I figure. But that's just in time to see the sinewy tail head past.
You should have left him a note. You'll get this back and
see you in 100 years.
See you in 100 years.
And then there's a roar. And a gout of flame enters the hallway as you start to climb down.
Okay.
So you can the lip right there by the door gets very hot.
I think we made it mad. I know, go. So we start climbing.
Sorry, give me another climb check.
Alright.
Everybody make climbing rolls.
12.
I don't like it.
How much do you don't like it?
It's a 9.
Enough that you were handing me cards, so yeah. I guess it was pretty significant.
18.
Okay. So neither one of you falls.
Well, that's good.
And we'll say that you were successful enough not to draw a ton of attention as you pass the areas where there are now guards moving about. And you can hear them pounding through the hallways as you head down the shaft.
Okay. I'll refrain.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
But he's a bad mother.
Shut your mouth.
Well, that's better than what I thought where you were going to go.
I was going to go there, but I thought better of it.
All right, so you skitter down the last little bits, and then the smell starts to roll up from below.
What a wonderful smell you've discovered.
You're very welcome.
Rotting vegetables and
meat. There's probably lots and lots of rotting meat.
Well, no one told me this job was all you can eat.
Lots of meat. All right, so we head down till we get to the floor approximately where the kitchen is, because that's going to be probably the least guarded area.
You're going to try to get out.
Probably closest to the docks, too.
That's kind of what I'm thinking, yes.
Okay.
So that's where we're going.
Okay. So you slip out, or attempt to slip out, into the hallway in the kitchen corridor.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead and give me a stealth roll.
9. And I only have 1 XP left. And
I will give you each an XP because you managed to find the scepter and get it.
Okay, well, why don't you just keep it so I can reroll this 9?
Okay.
Oh, man, give it back. I only got a 9.
That's not how this works.
I feel like I've been cheated.
2s and 5s.
I know. I'm going to have to sit on this 9. I'm not rolling it again. I may need another XP later.
Okay. So you step out into the corridor.
Scott didn't even roll.
Well, you were going first.
Oh, okay.
So you okay. step out of the shaft into the corridor.
Uh-huh.
Who's carrying the bag?
I am.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Okay.
I figured.
I thought I had it.
Well, I don't know. Can all five pieces fit in a single bag? I kind of figured we were both carrying parts of it.
Might be both carrying parts
of it. I'm thinking we're both carrying parts of it, because...
I'm willing to go with that.
Okay.
So you step out. Sense. You step out into the hallway. Uh-huh. You don't think you've gotten anybody's attention.
Okay.
It looks clear.
Okay. Then I move to the side so he can get out.
Okay. Go ahead and give me your stealth roll. Because you can hear... You can hear... noise from the kitchen.
Hurry up.
Jiminy Crispies.
Hurry up.
Holy cow.
I've never seen Scott go through so much XP.
16.
Thank God.
Wow. He's been hoarding it just for this moment.
We should have thought to grab ourselves some kitchen gear, but
oh, we're here now. We can do it.
All right.
I don't know that we have time to change. Now we just need to get off this place.
So as you step out into the hallway, the kitchen door is open.
Okay.
And we're going to put a break in.
Oh, no, we're going to put a break in. We already broke in.
Ta-da.
Ta-da, we'll see you guys in a little bit.
Well, that's my line. It's right there in the chat.
Is it ta-da? Really?
Yeah, he probably said it. He says
oh,
it all the
really?
Time.
Wow. Okay.
All right.
Bye.